أويه
أو بدو يوم ربع؟
إيه نعم.
قرب رمز ماني يا رجال.
الله يبارك
ويب دناي.
الله يبارك بيك ويخلي.
يا مرحبا.
ويا هينو وخرا.
إن شاء الله.
عش ترفي عش ترفي عش رجال تمام مسكين عش إيه والله توفي من حلوة مريم مريم.
الزوجة الثانية الحين.
إيه نعم.
من قريب.
وبعد بعده.
إيه نعم.
وبعد أبوه.
The Shahi of course are UAE citizens. They are now so much mingled with the other tribes in the UAE. They used to be a speech community by themselves, talking about geographical land in the past, because they used to be, they lived in seclusion for quite some time, taking the land, the type of land that they used to behind mountains and top of mountains. But I think now they have, with the intermarriage that happens between them and the other tribes, they are intermingled now with the rest of the UAE. And they are so proud of their patronymy, by the way. They are so proud of themselves and of their dialects.
Really, it's already affected. Now, as we say, there we have the city types. Everyone living in the city. So the mountains guys are moving to the city. The coastal guys are moving to the city. Especially the before our grandfathers are living in the mountains, by the mountains, and they are have their food from the mountains, from the sea. But now the workplace are in the city, in governments, in the governments or in the private sector. So that's moving, making people mixing together. So in the future, I think it's not a dangerous for a Shahi accent only. It will be affected on all accents. And we will become on a mixed white accent, joining all the society with one, only one accent.
Well, the Shuh, in fact, as a community, a speaking community, they are very distinguished when they speak. And you can tell them, if you are moving in a land, moving, for example, in Ras Al Khaimah, and you move to the area where the Shuh are actually settling, your ears will automatically pick up that there are certain sound system, that words are pronounced a bit differently from what the ear is used to hear in the local dialect. And the sound ah, for example, that you would hear it in the local dialect of UAE, it is pronounced like ah, which is, we call it glottal stop. So the word arba'a, that we pronounce it, they say arba, arba. Also the R, which is a retroflex. The R in the Arabic, it's normal R, but in the Shahi dialect, you will hear them that they are sort of rolling up their tongue when they pronounce the R. So they say R, 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 ba.
خبرنا
بالانجليزي وكلمه خبرني بالانجليزي كان يتكلم
ايه
هو ما يعرف عربي
لحبوه شلون يبقاهم
في منطقه الحبس
الليل 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 هذا الليل
منطقه
الليل 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 اهل الليل هذا لحبوه وصل وصل
سيد وبختي that's when I'm shocked like it's me like what my luck is in English I have in الشحي وبختي So I use it a lot. also, my father said, "Waghshi," يعني like I black out, you know, from the news or something I hear, I say, "Waghshi," that's I will black out. خلاص, I will lose.
كل شيء ده تمام. لو شو هتكلموا كلهم بلاهم. شيء ده. بام ييل بام قلت هذيك لازم محبة وداك بام تبعك ورزي ولا لا لا لكان بلعب رصاص تماتيك ماشي ما هم سمع ما هم يادر ما هم هذي سرحلة
this is something part of the history of this land and I think the Shahi represent an era of evolution of the language itself. I mean, if we talk about language origin and language development, it represents a good example of how language develops. And it's for me as a linguist, I mean, I look at Shahi language from the historical point of view, from sociolinguists, sociolinguistics point of view, from a cultural point of view. I think it is as important as archaeological excavation. Language is just part of the documentation of the history of the people. Maybe people will die, maybe excavation will go, but the language will remain. We always say that language and the vocabulary of the language would remain forever, and we have to preserve it.
خصابة ثانية.
ما شاء الله.
نعم.
الحمد لله.